The South Sudanese like to joke that alcohol has a special meaning for them. They fought a bloody two-decade-long war so they could enjoy a cold beer at the end of a long, hot day. Alcohol used to be banned in Sudan after the northern Khartoum-based government brought in Sharia law in 1983. The people in the South voted in a January 2011 referendum to separate and form Africa's newest state. In 2009, SABMiller built the region's first factory in order to brew a light, crisp lager suitable for the country's arid climate. The name White Bull Lager was chosen because of the distinctive cattle of the country. Busk was given its toughest challenge yet. How do we advertise a beer in a country where the lack of infrastructure limits media operations? We spotted an opportunity and moved quickly to sponsor this fledgling nation's military, creating the world's first branded army, the White Bull Army. We designed vehicle wraps with a White Bull livery for the SPLM military vehicles. And we even got a brand on the official Army uniform. The results were astounding. The White Bull Army quickly became a phenomenon and immediately went viral. The first week, White Bull Channel had over 80 million views worldwide and became the all-time most viewed channel in YouTube history. White Bull Army was the most popular search term on Twitter for 2 weeks. 156 unofficial Facebook fan pages were set up in just 10 days. Countless articles on blogs appeared, and at the latest count, there have been over 729 newspaper articles worldwide about South Sudan's White Bull Army. And best of all, if fighting does flare up in the future, our brand will be seen by millions on TV news channels worldwide. White Bull is now the most popular beer in South Sudan. It's become so popular, the brewery is set to launch White Bull in 80 different countries. In the end, we didn't just launch a beer. We launched a country.